This is me, Anthony Marks. I grew up here. It's just a normal village to look at. But this one has a dark secret. Above the village, hidden behind those trees, stands Margam Manor, once home to the Talbot family. I know very little about my family, except that they worked on the Margam estate for generations, and that my grandmother, Marion Marks, was born there. I never met her, and I'd like to tell you why. As the story goes, Marion Marks was a fine woman, blessed with striking beauty. Men fell at her feet. One of those was the eldest son of the Talbot family, Gale Cornelius Talbot, a cruel and greedy man. He fell in love with Marion's beauty and offered her his hand. But Marion had fallen for a poor woodcutter. With no money or prospects, they hid their forbidden love. But when Marion found herself pregnant, the woodcutter, knowing he could never marry her, told her what she must do. Marion married Gale Talbot within a month, and shortly after that announced that she was pregnant with their first child. But the fiery-haired, pale-skinned baby girl had an undeniable resemblance to the woodcutter.
Is it a sin? Is it a crime? Loving you dear like I do? If it's a crime, then I'm guilty. Guilty of loving you.
One night, in a furious, drunken stupor, Gale Talbot mounted the stairs to his chamber where Marion lay nursing the baby and took a flaming torch to the dry wooden door. Within 10 minutes, the entire east wing was in flames. Everyone in the manor was burned to death, including, it is believed, Gale Talbot himself. But there was one survivor, however, the fiery-haired, pale-skinned daughter of Marion and the woodcutter. Her name is Stephanie, and she is my mother. No one knows how she survived. It's said that she was found lying in her cradle, unscathed, surrounded by the crumbling, blackened walls. I know this story not through her, as she refused to speak of it, but through the villagers, whose ghostly whisperings filled my childhood. The story I heard time and again was that of the ghost of a young woman of striking beauty wandering the grounds. It is said that each morning she returns to her room, hoping to find her baby asleep in the cot. She picks up the blanket, which she cradles in her arms, and holds it tightly to her chest, rocking it gently. I never believed these stories and never saw the ghost of this woman until today. I was cycling home from work and was killed when a car pulled out in front of me. Her beauty astounded me, and I knew she was my grandmother, Marion Marks. I took her hand and walked with her, leaving my dead body behind, up the hill towards Margam Manor. In years to come, the house and estate will be bought by the National Trust. Visitors and staff will report sightings of a young couple dancing together in the shadows.